Hello, everyone, and welcome to this Coliseum video exclusive presentation of WrestleFest from the Louisiana Superdome in New Orleans. I'm Sean Mooney, and I'm delighted to say I'm joined by the one and only Lord Alfred Hayes.
Well, thank you, Sean. It is truly an honor to be here, and what a night of action we have in store.
The opening contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Portland, Oregon, weighing 241 pounds, Matt Borne.
His opponent from Richmond, Virginia, weighing 238 pounds.
What a pleasure it is to be here in the Superdome, and what a night we have ahead of us. The Hulkster teaming with Andre the Giant to meet the team of Rowdy Roddy Piper and Bob Orton, Orndorff and the Superfly in a cage, the tag team titles on the line, and the Junkyard Dog against the Natural. All that and so much more on this Coliseum video exclusive.
And just look at this amazing building, absolutely packed to the rafters.
And these two men, no strangers to this venue.
Dick Slater looking for an early submission.
Nice work from Borne to escape that hold.
The fans here, clearly behind Dick Slater, they're not at all impressed by Borne.
And Borne raking the eyes of the rebel across that top rope.
Oh my goodness.
A vicious move by Matt Borne that may well put Slater out of it.
And Borne taunting the crowd. He really should be pressing home the advantage. He has Slater right where he wants him.
Borne needs to be careful here. He doesn't want to be counted out.
And apparently he doesn't want to take the count out victory.
Oh, well, that may have been a mistake. Two. Oh, into the barricade. Four. Oh, big time fist from Slater.
Nice knee to the back of the head.
Picks him up, right, and slams him down. To the cover, but only a two count. Abdominal stretch.
Will Borne submit? Nice counter by Borne. These are two crafty veterans in there, two ring generals.
Oh, headbutt, nothing pretty about that.
No, but it's very effective.
Side Russian leg sweep.
And every time one man seems to have the advantage, his opponent turns the tables.
And now it's Borne very much on top.
But see, as soon as you say that, Slater comes fighting back. This has been a grueling battle.
Nice counter from Slater, rolls him up. No. Another nice counter from Slater.
Swinging neck breaker.
Into the cover. Yes, he got him. The Rebel Dick Slater victorious here to kick us off at WrestleFest.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a tag team attraction scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute time limit. Hailing from parts unknown, ladies and gentlemen, here comes Demolition!
What a matchup this should be, Your Lordship.
Absolutely. Two of the very best teams in the world today. And we have that World Tag Team title match coming up a little bit later on. Well, I would suggest that the winners of this one will be right in contention for a shot at whomever emerges from tonight with the tag team belts.
Barry Windham trying for a slam, but Axe was having none of it.
The potential in a man like Barry Windham is unlimited. This youngster can go as far in the sport as he wants to.
And now here comes Rotunda. Rotunda, graduate of Syracuse University, where he wrestled and played football.
Nice drop toe hold. And Rotunda has the right idea. Axe and Smash are brawlers. Rotunda is in there trying to wrestle with them.
And here comes Smash. And I couldn't help but notice, Your Lordship, that despite the fact they are managed by the nefarious Mr. Fuji, Demolition received quite the reception when they made their entrance for this match.
Yes, I noticed that too.
And now Smash with the Boston Crab, but he was too close to the ropes. Oh, Axe is just a bully.
I don't think Axe is as concerned with beating his opponent as he is with hurting them.
Seven, Remember, still to come, the big tag team main event. Suplex by Rotunda, nicely executed. And into the cover, no. And the tag to Barry Windham. Float over DDT by Barry Windham.
And now Windham is going for the figure four leg lock.
And he has it locked in there, although it's hard to imagine Smash submitting. I don't think we've seen that happen before. And Smash turns him over, and now the pressure is on Windham. Inverted atomic drop. Oh, and the rake of the eyes, and the officials should be doing something about that.
Windham couldn't get across to make the tag. It doesn't look like he has much left in the tank.
Maybe he has more than we think. There's that claw hold.
Oh, Axe is such a powerful man.
Windham went for that lariat, but Axe ducked it. Oh, that was close. And another eye rake by Smash. Oh, beautiful counter by Rotunda, and he plants Smash with a DDT.
Superb technique shown by Rotunda there.
Oh, lariat.
And Windham got caught up with Smash there. He took his eye off the legal man, Axe, and is paying for it now.
And there's that crossface submission maneuver. This may be it. And no, there's still a lot of fight left in Barry Windham. Double axe handle. And now that cross-face submission by Axe on Rotunda. And Rotunda fights out of it.
What a battle this has been.
Scoops him up and slams him down. He got him. And shall we say a frosty reception for Nikolai Volkoff here in New Orleans. Listen to the ovation for the Hacksaw.
They love him, Sean.
There's been a big rivalry between these two men ever since Hacksaw Jim Duggan arrived in the World Wrestling Federation. And I don't see things cooling down between them anytime soon.
No, certainly not. Both men are simply polar opposites of the other, in their beliefs, in their heritage, in their way of life.
Duggan looking to end this one early. And now Volkoff seeking to inflict some punishment.
Certainly we shouldn't expect much finesse in this contest. These are two big bruising men, fighters rather than wrestlers.
Oh, and Volkoff pledging his allegiance to the Soviet Union. The fans here in New Orleans don't like hearing that. And now Duggan back on the offensive. Nice drop kick to the back of Volkoff's head. And now Duggan starting the USA chant.
European uppercut.
Shoulder breaker. And a two count. And Flick trying to influence things, but he's not having much luck. Oh, Volkoff got out of the way. Oh, a big forearm right to the face of Duggan, dropping him to the mat. And now Volkoff with a blatant choke. Referee, get in there.
Nikolai's on top now. The fans here aren't happy.
Oh, but what a move by the Hacksaw. Headbutt. And now Duggan and Slick exchanging words.
And I think Slick backed off pretty quickly there.
Big clothesline. Into the cover, no, almost.
Nice power slam by Volkoff.
Volkoff was looking for a suplex, but Duggan fought it off.
Volkoff tried to clothesline Duggan on the top rope, but Duggan rebounded, and there's a big boot.
Thank you. And now Duggan looking for it. Yes, nailed it. He got him. Mr. Wrestling number two, a legend of the sport, and certainly a legend in this part of the country.
Yes, but let's not forget Dick Murdoch is a veteran in his own right, and these fans in New Orleans are very familiar with him also.
And Wrestling 2 showing early on why he has garnered the moniker of Mr. Wrestling. Nice reversal by Murdoch. Oh, and Wrestling 2 sent down onto the arena floor.
And Murdoch trying to turn this into a fight rather than a wrestling match.
Into the post, and if you want to fight, Mr. Wrestling 2 can go that way too. And Murdoch ducked the clothesline, and there's a back rake.
We shouldn't be surprised to see Dick Murdoch bending the rules, shall we say.
Wrestling 2 ducks the clothesline and delivers one of his own. Into the cover.
And there's a leg vine.
missed with the drop kick, but he connected with that one. And there's that patented running knee lift. That is the favorite maneuver of Mr. Wrestling 2. Got him.
Yes, few men get up after that running knee lift by Mr. Wrestling 2.
Here is your winner, Mr. Wrestling 2.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first the manager,
for the Junkyard Dogs.
Fans, I wish you could be here to experience this with us. There are few people in history who will ever have received a reception like the one the Junkyard Dog has just received here in the Superdome in New Orleans.
The Junkyard Dog feeding off this crowd, he says these people are his people. And it is quite obvious he was telling the truth.
And the Slickster, obviously worried about the way things are going for his man, he feels the need to intervene.
And every time the Junkyard Dog retaliates towards Reed, these people go crazy.
The Natural would love nothing more than to humiliate the Junkyard Dog right here in the Superdome. Backbreaker by Reed. And now listen to this. This crowd is not impressed by the Natural.
Beautiful suplex by Reed.
and Slick again up on the ring apron.
Yes, but the Junkyard Dog needs to be smarter than this. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me.
Well, he didn't allow Reed to capitalize on it. There's a headbutt.
Butch Reed is a tough competitor.
Clothesline by the Dog. And Slick again, what's he doing?
It didn't work this time.
And there's the thump. Yes, he got him. I know when it comes to the British Bulldogs, it's difficult for you to remain impartial, Your Lordship, but this encounter has the potential to be an incredible matchup.
Yes, of course, I'm extremely proud of my countrymen, the world champions, but I shall try to remain neutral. I am a big admirer of the Hart Foundation also.
Of course, we know now about the family ties between these four men. Let me see if I can get this straight. Jim Neidhart is married to Bret Hart's sister, And Davey Boy Smith is married to another of Bret Hart's sisters. Is that right?
Yes, I believe so.
Is that all, or is there more?
I believe that Bret Hart and the Dynamite Kid are married to a pair of sisters.
Incredible. And here they all are competing for the most coveted tag team prize in the world. I wonder if Christmas dinner was a bit awkward yesterday.
Ha, yes, quite.
At the moment, it is the challengers who are on top as the Hitman goes to work on the Dynamite Kid. Swinging neckbreaker by the Dynamite Kid. And the tag to Davey Boy.
Davey Boy showboating, and he almost got punished for it. That's not the kind of behavior that led them to the titles. He'd do well to remember that.
And Davey Boy just sneaking out the back door that time. Back body drop by the Hitman.
And Hart targeting that leg, you often see that from him, he's always thinking about taking an opportunity to apply the sharpshooter later in the match.
And now a figure four leg lock. Just like you said, Your Lordship, if he doesn't get the submission now, he's weakening those legs for the sharpshooter later on.
And the Dynamite Kid is very aware of that. He broke that up post-haste.
The Hitman and the Anvil working together well. Into the cover.
And there's a bear hug by Neidhart. The brute power of the Anvil may be what tips this match in the Hart Foundation's favor.
And things just boiling over a little bit now. We know the respect these four men have for each other, but it's just getting a little bit tasty out there, Your Lordship.
Yes, and what a display of power from Davey Boy Smith, pressing the almost 300-pound Neidhart over his head.
I think the Hart Foundation have edged this one so far, Your Lordship.
Yes, I agree. I think perhaps they have been slightly more aggressive than the champions were anticipating.
High-risk maneuver by Davey Boy did not pay off.
More good teamwork by the challengers.
And now a submission maneuver by the Anvil. Oh, that was kind of a cheap shot by Neidhart. He obviously wasn't happy with the Dynamite Kid for breaking up his submission attempt.
Temper's flaring a little bit out there. It's not surprising with the World Tag Team titles on the line.
And while Brett and Davey Boy are battling on the outside, Dynamite Kid and the Anvil are fighting on the floor. This one's getting out of control. Oh, and the Hitman missed a big splash.
Yes, but Hart was able to recover first. He looks like he has more in the tank than Davey Boy does.
And that was a display of sportsmanship by the Hitman. He went to check on Dynamite Kid, despite the fact he had Davey Boy Smith right where he wanted him in the ring.
But look what he's walked into. Oh, sportsmanship is lovely to see, but in truth it may prove foolish. He had the opportunity to press home the advantage for the world titles, and you don't get that chance often.
And now Dynamite Kid perched up there. Oh, he missed. Small package. And Davey Boy makes the save. Bulldog, a bulldog on the bulldog. And now a bulldog for the other bulldog.
Yes, but he didn't get all of that one.
And now Dynamite Kid with a bulldog of his own. Oh, he planted him. Oh, and a cheap shot by Bret Hart to the Dynamite Kid. Not much sportsmanship there.
And that was a little bit silly of Neidhart to allow Smith to make the tag. A lack of concentration.
Oh, power slam. This could be it. We could have new champions. You know, how close was that?
A whisker away from new world tag team champions.
Big clothesline by the Anvil.
But again, Neidhart allowed his opponent to make the tag.
But that was a big misjudgment by Davey Boy Smith. Figure four coming up. And Brett sends Dynamite crashing to the floor.
Yes, but Dynamite Kid is not the legal man, and now Davey Boy Smith has taken over on Hart.
Oh, gut-wrench slam, the power of Davey Boy.
Every little mistake is being punished in the match. Talk about fine margins. That's what we're dealing with when it comes to the world titles.
And now here it is, the sharpshooter. This could be it.
Davey Boy Smith holding on with grim determination.
Are we about to have new World Wrestling Federation tag team champions? No, Dynamite just got there to break it up before the Anvil could stop him. And now the cover, but Davey Boy got to the rope. And now just when it looked like we might have new champions, Davey Boy is rallying. Oh, slams him down.
And Hart landed hard on the back of his head.
And now Davey Boy scoops him up. And there's that running power slam. And that's it. The Bulldogs are still the champions.
What a match, Sean.
Absolutely incredible. Talk about bad blood, Your Lordship. The rivalry that has developed between these two superstars is at a level seldom seen in the World Wrestling Federation.
Yes, the events of the past few months have led to the necessity of this cage match, the most dangerous match in professional wrestling. but one which should hopefully draw a line under a rivalry which has become so bitter and so personal. Hopefully, their differences shall be settled tonight.
And normally in a match of this type, the only way to win is by escaping the cage. But due to where we are, the Superdome in New Orleans, the rule has been added that pinfalls will count. And Jimmy Snuka, he has been waiting for this moment. You can see months of pent-up aggression finally finding release.
But of course, Mr. Wonderful is one of the premier competitors in the World Wrestling Federation. Certainly, Jimmy Snuka has wanted and waited for this moment, but it will not be easy.
Certainly not, but at the moment, the Superfly is punishing Mr. Wonderful just like he has dreamed of. Leapfrog, another one, and nails him with a flying elbow. And now Snuka going up.
Oh, he didn't make it. Orndorff was too far away.
But Snuka up quickly. Oh, and Snuka connects with a flying clothesline from the second turnbuckle. Backbreaker. And now the Superfly feeling it. Oh, and Orndorff, a big moment from him, just when he needed it most.
Yes, an opportunity to catch his breath and his bearings will be most welcome from Mr. Wonderful.
And now Orndorff climbing the cage. He just wants to get out of there, take the win, and go home.
And he's up. This may be over.
Snuka in pursuit. Snuka brings him back, and now will Snuka escape? Oh, no. Second headbutt didn't connect. And now Orndorff taunting the crowd.
And imitating Hulk Hogan as well.
The Hulkster up next in the main event against Mr. Wonderful's close friends. Big clothesline by Snuka. And now is Snuka looking to escape? No. Drops the knee from the top rope right into the face of Mr. Wonderful.
And I think Mr. Wonderful is bleeding.
Yes, indeed. Paul Orndorff has been busted wide open. and Snuka. Another knee down across that bloody face. And a headbutt right on that laceration. And another one. Is he going to escape? Oh, he went for another knee drop and missed.
He went to the well once too often.
And now an armbar by Orndorff. Submissions do count, and he would love to force the Superfly to give up.
I don't know how much longer Jimmy Snuka can take this pain. There is no quit in him, but he could end up with a dislocated shoulder and a torn bicep.
But Snuka fighting out, like you said, Your Lordship, there is no quit in the Superfly. Trading chops. And a Superfly drop kick finds its mark. And now, are we going to see it? Yes, Superfly Splash. No, the Superfly gave up the pin. He wants to keep punishing Orndorff. And wait a minute. Pile driver.
What a colossal mistake by Jimmy Snuka.
Oh, and that's it. Orndorff wins it. Mr. Wonderful Victorian, what a battle it was, Your Lordship.
Yes, Jimmy Snuka can take solace in a tremendous performance, a tremendous effort, but that will be scant consolation for him.
And Andre is going to start us out here going against the ace cowboy, Bob Orton. And Orton trying to lock up with the giant. That was only going to end one way. Big chops by Andre. Those hands are like frying pans. And headbutts into the shoulder. Can you imagine, your lordship, being on the receiving end of a headbutt by Andre the Giant?
I'm afraid I can more than imagine it. I have been on the receiving end, and it is something I would prefer not to remember.
And a back body drop by the Giant. Orton must have come down from 10 feet in the air there.
That's the thing about Andre the Giant. His immense size and power simply means that everything he does is more devastating. Moves that simply hurt when another man inflicts it become agonizing when administered by the Giant.
And now Roddy Piper gonna try his luck with the Giant. And he fares about as well as Orton did. And now here he comes, the World Wrestling Federation champion.
And listen to the people.
They love him, no question about it. But right now it's Roddy Piper going to work on the Hulkster. And a big punch by the Hulkster. Oh, that one knocked Piper loopy. And Piper rams the champion's head into the turnbuckle. And now a blatant choke by Piper. And here comes the cowboy. Orton is enjoying being in a dominant position against the World Wrestling Federation champion.
Not for long. I think Hulk has been training with Andre. He's utilizing the headbutt a lot more than usual.
And they are very close, we know that. The Hulkster views Andre as a mentor. Neckbreaker. And a knee lift right into the face of the champion. And the Hulkster looking for the tag. Can he make it?
I'm a little perplexed at why Andre didn't reach out and make the tag himself there. It looked simple enough.
I'm sure he has all the faith in the world in the Hulkster, as do these people.
But that was close.
And now Andre, desperate for the tag, and gets it.
That was a mistake by Piper. Ah, but what a move.
Oh, clubbing blow by the Giant. And look at this. 500 pounds using you as a stepping stone. Oh, I think he caught him with the knee and the boot.
Oh, a bulldog by Piper on the Giant. What a maneuver.
Highly impressive. He is one of the best, no doubt about it. Inverted pile driver by Andre. Orton trying for a suplex, but the Hulkster blocking it. And there's the big leg. Into the cover. He got him. Leaving the champion to it as he gives these people what they want. It's like I am a real American. Fight for the rights of every man. I am a real American. Fight for what's right. Fight for your life. I feel strong. Thank you for joining us here on this Coliseum video release. For his lordship, I'm Sean Mooney, saying so long, everybody.